and SportsCenter coming up on News.
Good one.
Times Square, crowded, chaotic, confusing at first. A lot of action, a lot of distraction. Sort of like this year's Heisman Trophy race. There were sudden stops and starts, candidates arriving and departing as fast as the trains down below. We got six finalists here who traveled some very complicated paths. It was a lot to process. How much clarity can we find at the center of all this? We're about to find out real soon at this crazy crossroads.
Where creativity meets commerce, few things last forever. Yesterday's rage is today's relic. Rare is the brand that refuses to cater to the masses, that can ward off the infinite parade of fads, endlessly changing around it. For nearly 80 years, the Heisman has been that brand. Forever redefining the man without ever recasting the mold. Don't think Johnny Lujack transistor radio, RG3 iPod. Johnny Lujack was the iPod. Archie Griffin wasn't a rotary phone. He's high-speed Wi-Fi. Physical testaments to Heisman's enduring brand, who try so hard and make it look so easy, that can overpower and instill awe. Models of integrity and ingenuity. And now, the college football world awaits the unveiling of the latest model. The Texas Rebel, for whom playbooks don't apply. The famous freshman who put Tallahassee back on the map. BC's back, breaking tackles and records all season long. Northern Illinois' man under center, giving new meaning to what a QB can be. Auburn's elusive Tiger, pouncing on the spotlight when it burned the brightest. The senior from Tuscaloosa, who measures success solely in championships. Each hoping to have this name forever spoken before his own. Heisman Trophy winner.
And welcome. A few steps and an escalator ride below Times Square sits the Best Buy Theater, home of the Heisman Trophy presentation. Tonight, the 79th Heisman Trophy winner will be announced in this room, surrounded by past Heisman winners. The great Barry Sanders is here celebrating his silver anniversary, the most amazing year any back has ever had. The Fighting Irish, represented by Paul Horning and John Lattner, the senior member here tonight. Doug Flutie, bursting with BC Eagles pride, supporting Andre Williams. Chris Wenke, hoping a third Florida State Seminole will join the club tonight of Heisman winners and championship quarterbacks. And Archie Griffin, the only two-time winner in the trophy's history. Of course, last year's winner back as a finalist. Let's set them all up.
From Texas A&M, quarterback Johnny Manziel, scampering around. He'll get away from one guy. Did he? Yeah, he got away from him. He's going to throw it up for grabs. And here is a... Oh, it's a catch! Oh, my. Oh, wow. Good race. Can they catch it? Touchdown! How about that?
From Alabama, quarterback A.J. McCarron.
Here's A.J. throwing a straight down the middle. A beauty of a throw. Rolling right. The pass from A.J. Touchdown, Alabama! AJ's going to throw out of the end zone. Down the near side, he's got it. He's going to go 99 yards, count it.
From Northern Illinois, quarterback Jordan Lynch. Lynch looking to go straight ahead. He's going to spin away from one, and there's nowhere to go. Oh, it broke the tackle. Lynch never went down. Straight up the gun he goes. 10, 5, and he's in. Made it look easy once again. Going to throw it back to Jordan Lynch. Makes the catch, changes direction. Goal line. Touchdown, Huskies.
From Boston College, running back Andre Williams.
Andre Williams runs a man over. The incredible Andre Williams. Get on your horse, Andre. See you later, A-Train. See you later. Take a bow, Andre Williams.
From Auburn University, Trey Mason.
Hand off to Mason, dances his way, and traffic spins away into the open field, into the end zone.
By the hair of my chinny chin chin, Trey Mason on that drive. He's in. You may put this one on ice.
The quarterback from Florida State University, Jameis Winston.
Winston looking, has time, throws a pass on the end zone, caught right on the numbers, and Winston throws a fastball. Winston looks, he's going to be, he got away from the sack, runs to his right, goes down the end zone, caught! What a remarkable Houdini job by Jameis Winston, calling famous Jameis. That is a remarkable play.
Six Heisman Trophy finalists makes for a very up-tempo show, and welcome to New York, a proud night for all of us at ESPN. I'm Chris Fowler. Well, six matches the number from 1994 when Rashan Salaam lifted that guy right there. It's 25 pounds, but any of these legends out here will tell any of these guys it carries a lot more weight. Johnny, you're the one that knows what it's like to hear your name called. What did it make you feel like to see your family's reaction 1 year ago here?
It was awesome to have so many family members here and to spend that special moment with them. To be here and break the freshman barrier, and just a great trip, and to be welcomed into a fraternity with some of the greatest, funniest, best guys on the face of the earth. I couldn't be happier.
What's the best question these guys have asked you about what it feels like?
It's hard to describe, man. I would try to sit here and tell them, hey, be prepared for this, be prepared for that. But if these guys are able to pull it off, they'll find out for their own.
Jameis, you won a Heisman Trophy back in 2006. Competing against fellow video gamers, okay? Now that you're this close to that trophy, does it begin to feel surreal, the chance to maybe win it, not in the pretend world?
Oh, it's amazing, man, because one thing about this Heisman Trophy is I can touch this one. I mean, I can touch my TV all I want, but I can actually touch this one. So, it's amazing. I'm blessed.
Video games, no substitute for the real thing. Andre, you are a gifted practitioner of the stiff arm. You throw guys to the ground all season long. You're also an aspiring writer, so critique that statue's form for me.
You know, I say he has great form. He's got the full arm extension, great center of gravity. I think he's going to do damage with that one.
That's why the man is an aspiring writer. Now, Trey, my man Desmond Howard invented the pose. You struck it a couple times while running through Missouri. His kids gave it a 3 on a scale of 1 to 10. I'm just saying. They're tough graders, though.
Hey, that's the specialist right there. He's up to it. He does it, so.
Now, you and Andre know what it's like to come through some tough seasons. Between you, your team's won 5 games. How does that make an hour like this, a season like this, feel even sweeter?
You know, this is a great opportunity to be here. You know, our team's worked so hard, you know, to be where we are today. You know, I played against a couple of these guys that I'm sitting next to, and it's just an honor to be here with them.
Jordan, one school said you're good enough to play quarterback for us. You've said that being here is kind of a personal triumph, but what does it also represent to people everywhere who've been told you better lower your expectations?
Right, it gives a lot of people hope. You know, all the kids going to the mid-major schools, you know, anything's possible if you just work at it and, you know, give it everything you have.
Guy from the south side of Chicago, what do you think of New York, your first visit here?
Yeah, I'm kind of used to it. The snow and everything, you know, it's a little nicer weather here than back at home. But, you know, it's a great city, and, you know, I got a chance to try some of their pizza, and I have to say Chicago pizza is the best.
No. No. You can go sit down right now. That big glob of dough compared to, like, a nice, thin New York slice, forget about it. AJ, it's also your first visit here to New York. Mobile is a little bit warmer than this. We talked earlier. You know how to manage each situation in life perfectly. How do you manage the next hour?
Just live in the moment, have fun. You know, all these guys, like they said, and it's just truly a blessing to be here and a dream come true.
You had a train ride from Baltimore. You won the Unitas there. You arrive on a snowy morning. What's your impression of the Big Apple so far on your first time?
It's too cold. it's different from Mobile down south, being on the water and out in the sun all day, I'll tell you that.
Some of you guys are soft. You see Army Navy play today in a blizzard? Come on, if they can handle it, now you can. Well, there are 6 finalists here. The stage is crowded, but of course there just is one Heisman Trophy. The announcement inside the next hour of the 79th Heisman Trophy winner coming up from New York City.
Good evening, I'm Brian Oberfell, and on behalf of the Heisman Trustees, welcome to the 79th presentation of the Heisman Trophy. The Heisman Trust was formed to protect the integrity of the Heisman Trophy and to generate funds for worthy causes. Over the past few years, more than $5 million has been donated to charity. This was only possible through the gracious support of our sponsors, Nissan, Wendy's, Aflac, and Kellogg. Now enjoy tonight's ESPN telecast of the exciting conclusion of this year's Heisman race.
Ready to run your lines?
Okay. Who helps you focus on your recovery?
Yo, 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 Aflac.
Wow. That was horrible. Pays you cash when you're sick or hurt.
Aflac.
Love it.
Hate it.
Helps you focus on getting back to normal.
Aflac.
Aflac.
Aflac, uh-uh.
I am so fired.
You're on in five, Duck.
When you're sick or hurt, Aflac pays you cash. Find out more at Aflac.com.
Take game day to the next level at the new sports bar at Dave & Buster's. Get in the action with massive TVs, plus fuel your fun with $5 apps and beer specials, and play new games in the midway. Dave & Buster's, the only place to watch the games and play the games.
I did it.
I did it.
Yes. The student has become the master.
Control YouTube from your smartphone or tablet with the Vizio M-Series Smart TV. It's beautifully simple.
Their army is infinite.
We are 47.
Once the war begins, there is no turning back.
Introducing the Rack Roll Down, the lowest prices ever at Rent-A-Center. We've rolled down prices on your favorite brands throughout the store. Everyone's pre-approved for our new lower prices, so hurry in and save like never before at Rent-A-Center.
Monday Night Football, Ravens, Lions, 8:25 Eastern on ESPN.
The 2013 Heisman Trophy presentation is presented by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy, and in part by the New York Marriott Marquis, the ultimate Times Square experience, and Aflac, official partner of the Heisman Trophy.
The Auburn Tiger Walk tradition recreated here in New York for Trey Mason as it was for Cam Newton in 2010. They're covered there, but in the meantime, a blizzard has arrived here in the Northeast. A lot of snow in New York. Hope these guys enjoy the city and may be staying for a while. Alabama's only Heisman Trophy winner, Mark Ingram, edged Toby Gerhart 3 years ago, the closest race ever, gave us a tearful, powerful speech and shared credit with everybody who's helped get him here. And watching that night was Alabama's backup quarterback that season, A.J. McCarron. Since then, A.J. and the senior class have only lifted the tide higher, winning more games than any Alabama group before them. The bigger the stage, the better A.J. plays. He wasn't supposed to live to see his sixth birthday after a terrible wave runner accident. Doctors told A.J.'s parents that he wouldn't make it.
But coming through that reinforced his faith that special things awaited if he fully dedicated himself. He has.
Unselfish, disciplined, trusted. AJ's QB IQ manages each moment, calculates what best serves each situation, calibrates risk with a keen eye on the big picture. In Bama's rare shootouts, AJ shifts gears, probing, pushing the ball to the right receiver in the perfect spot. He senses when to ignite teammates, when to calm them, even when to feed them. AJ has earned his coach's faith, calling crucial plays himself. A short toss to put away the Aggies. A 99-yard heave to grab the lead at Auburn.
Of course, the Tide fell short that night, but AJ's big game rep was only strengthened. 8 games versus top 10 teams, 15 touchdown passes, only 2 interceptions. Threw only 13 picks in his entire 4-year career so far. He's very proud of that. Of course, McCarron and Manziel will always be linked by 2 classic duels. For Johnny, it was always going to be really hard to top his historic Heisman rookie season. By most measures, he's an even better quarterback this season that took serious work against defenses obsessed with disrupting him. But through all the preseason static and the late season pain, Johnny Football, the sequel, was still must-see TV.
The mesmerizing Mr. Manziel. The Aggies' magnetic force, focal point of opponents' plotting. Foes still fear his quick escape scampers. But there's less freelance, more framework. The sport's most instinctive free spirit, embracing structure. Drilling the fine points of pocket passing paid off with improved production and efficiency. But Johnny still makes magic. A legacy of special plays and epic days. Vividly remembered for as long as football tales are told.
He got away from him. Now he's running for his life. He's going to throw it up for grabs. Oh, it's a catch!
In the proud history of the SEC, Johnny is responsible for the first, second, and third biggest games in total offense, including that big game against the Crimson Tide this year. These two SEC quarterback legends linked together back here in the green room. I guess it's fitting that the personal and team scoreboard was 1-1 in those games. You guys are different style quarterbacks. What do you appreciate about the way AJ plays the position?
I mean, you have to appreciate what he does and how he commands his team and how he really leads that Alabama football team. To do what he's done and rack up the amount of wins that he has has been impressive to watch.
You're called on to do very different things in Nick Saban's structure. You ever watch Johnny play and say, freelancing, that would be a lot of fun?
Well, I just told him I hate watching that one clip how he spun out of 8 sacks and then completed a pass. I mean, the guy makes those type of plays on almost every drive, and all you do is try to minimize them because, I mean, the guy's, he won the Heisman last year. He's one of the best players in the country by far.
Every guy that's had his name called is really unprepared for how it impacts. How is the guy sitting here right now different than the guy who was sitting awaiting the announcement a year ago, Johnny?
Being here this trip, it feels like a weight has just been lifted off my shoulders. Just being back here, I'm getting to see these familiar faces and just a lot more at ease. I've had a long time to sit and reflect and learn and just really, really continue to grow up. And I'm feeling continuing to get better at that.
There's the scrutiny off the field. There's the attention you get on the field. A lot of trash was talked your way. What was the most challenging thing about carrying around that Heisman Trophy with you?
It was tough. People would come at you no matter what. People really were gunning for us this year, and we got their best shot. And being a competitor, I was completely okay with that. It was a little different wearing that trophy on your back pretty much everywhere you went around.
AJ, you've had a dream career for team success. Quarterbacks could only imagine what it's like to have a couple of national championships. You actually have 3. You only have 3 losses in your career. Individual honors have come more slowly. What's the difference in how they make you feel?
I don't think there's any difference. I think, you know, the name on it's a little different from the University of Alabama to my name, but it's still a team achievement. You know, I can't thank my teammates enough back home for everything they've allowed me to accomplish. Those guys deserve all the credit.
We'll miss you in college football. Kirk, I hope these guys at the next level face off in more duels. Fans need to see that.
Oh, that'd be fun to see that at the next level, Chris. But back here with Dez and Coach, and We all know it's been a kind of a crazy year for the Heisman Trophy. And Chris talking there with Johnny, there's always pressure on these players to perform, but he really had pressure.
Well, this year, more than any other player, he had the pressure because he's trying to win the Heisman the second time. He had a great year. But the thing that impressed me most, he had over 500 total yards and accounted for 5 touchdowns in the losses to Alabama and Alabama and Auburn. No, two great teams. And Dez, the thing about it, he's a great competitor.
He is.
Every time he played the best, he played the best.
Coach, I agree with you. I always say that Johnny Manziel brought Cirque du Soleil to college football. must-see TV watching Johnny. How about Jordan Lynch of Northern Illinois? I got a chance to watch this young man play twice live and in person. He was so impressive. I mean, I thought that he was the Tim Tebow of the MAC division. He broke the single-season rushing record for quarterbacks twice. He broke the single-game rushing record for quarterbacks twice. And he was the heart and soul of the Huskies. And talking about running the ball, Andre Williams, the running back at Boston College, quietly put together over 200-yard rushing total, and he just threw guys off of him all the time, ran with so much conviction. These guys are more than deserving of being here tonight. I'm glad to see them in attendance.
Yeah, another running back, obviously, Trey Mason. His Auburn's brand awareness kind of went through the roof. He, along with Nick Marshall, had a lot to obviously do with that. And Chris just talked with A.J. McCarron. I mean, you talk about a guy, only 3 losses his entire career. But the thing that might go unnoticed is quarterbacks are always getting their team into a good play. He got his offense out of bad plays, and that doesn't always show up. But we have 6 very worthy candidates, Chris, here tonight.
It was your good point, Kirk, that by not focusing on individual awards, that in large part helped these guys get here. Well, a new member of the Heisman family is welcomed shortly. Tonight, we also sadly salute one whom we've lost. Dick Kazmaier was a single-wing, triple-threat tailback, 1951's brightest star, who came back here each year with such tremendous pride. He's remembered by another Princeton legend who wore number 42.
When I was 9 years old, playing pickup football in the churchyard across from my house in Crystal City, Missouri, I imagined I was Heisman Trophy winner Dick Kazmaier, who played for some college I never heard of called Princeton. Other kids wanted to be Hopalong Cassidy of Ohio State. I wanted to be Dick Kazmaier. May seem impossible to imagine now, but there was a time when an Ivy League football player was the most famous sportsman in America. The year was 1951, the player Dick Kazmaier. A 2-time All-American, Dick led the nation in total offense that year, guiding Princeton to a 9-0 record, part of a 22-game winning streak. Major accolades followed. First, there was the cover of Time magazine, Male Athlete of the Year from AP. Ben Hogan and Stan Musial were the runners-up. Voters for the Heisman picked Kazmaier by what was at the time the largest margin in the award's history. He remains the last Ivy Leaguer to win it. Dick was drafted by the Chicago Bears, but turned down the NFL, knowing he wanted to chase new goals. A loving father of 6 daughters, Dick was a strong advocate for the growth of women's sports, and he played a key role in the passage of Title IX. His commitment to that cause lives on with the Patty Kazmaier Award, given annually to the outstanding player in women's college ice hockey. During his time in the spotlight, and long after it faded, Kaz was a man who never thought himself a celebrity. That quiet, self-effacing nature is what we remember. A man who lived a life worthy of our admiration, even though he insisted it wasn't.
Okay, halftime.
Now this
is my favorite play.
Oh. I'm wide open. I won't fumble. Don't want to fumble any of these.
Share what you love with who you love. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Is up. And it's good.
Good. They're great.
You're saying I can get AT&T's network with a data plan and unlimited talk and text for as low as $45 a month?
$45 a month.
Wow. No annual contract?
No annual contract.
No long-term agreement?
No long-term agreement.
Really?
Really.
Okay, so what's the catch?
There is no catch.
Okay, I'm obviously getting nowhere with you. I'm gonna need to speak with the supervisor.
I am the supervisor.
Oh, finally, someone I can talk to.
It's not complicated. New smartphone plans starting at $45 a month with no annual contract. Only from AT&T.
The Rose, Fiesta, Sugar, Orange, and the 2014 Vizio BCS National Championship. ESPN, the BCS lives here.
Where is Porat? Touchdown!
It was two heroes from Youngstown. We had a chance to hook up with one another.
Maurice was about more than football. And we did talk a lot about his greater purpose.
They loved him, but they were quick to turn on him.
What if I told you they were undefeated on the field, but under fire off of it? ESPN Films presents a 30 for 30 film, Youngstown Boys, next on ESPN.
I see a world bursting with opportunity, with ideas, with ambition. I'm thinking about China, Brazil, India. The world's a big place. I want to be a part of it.
iShares International ETFs, access to developed markets, emerging markets, and single countries. Find out why 9 out of 10 large professional investors choose iShares for their ETFs. iShares by BlackRock. Call 1-800-iShares for a prospectus, which includes investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses. Read and consider it carefully before investing. Risk includes possible loss of principal.
Down here. How can I help you, big man?
I'm looking for something to make my party pop off.
Check out the Beats Pill. I'm portable, but don't let my small size fool you. I'm loud. And when I say Bluetooth, I'm not talking about my beautiful hue, baby.
But will it make my party pop off?
This is some mythical unicorn stuff, man.
R.I.P. Yeah. R.I.P. Yeah. R.I.P. Yeah. R.I.P. I'm in a brand new drop top Rari with three breaks. Yeah. Tight to be in the middle of the trial with three stitches. And I...
Monday Night Football. The playoff race is heating up. Joe Flacco and the Ravens head to the Motor City to take on Megatron and the Lions. Monday Night Countdown at 6:30. Then the Ravens and the Lions, 8:25 Eastern Time on ESPN and also on the Watch ESPN app. Ex-Lion Hall of Famer Barry Sanders here tonight marking his silver anniversary. He was 6,700 miles from New York when his name was read. Cowboys are playing a game in Tokyo. Now, if you're old enough to remember his 88 season, you might share my belief that no one has ever been better than Barry. If you're not old enough to remember that, well, please pay attention right now.
It's like a law of sports talk physics. Every declaration must meet an equally passionate disagreement. The one exception.
Touchdown, Cowboys! Barry Sanders with the home run.
The best college season ever belonged to Barry Sanders, whose 1988 campaign for Oklahoma State made all the laws of physics look silly.
He's gone for a touchdown! Barry Sanders!
One season, 38 NCAA records, four 300-yard games, on the way to more than 2,600 yards on the ground. Numbers not padded against teams a notch below, but piled up consistently against all comers. Top 10 teams were no exception. He rolled for 189 against Nebraska and hung 215 on the Sooners.
We started running up huge statistics and played in the third quarter in some games, but a lot of them never got into the fourth quarter.
If we had left him in the ball game longer, he would have had 1,000 more yards.
Astonishing numbers, but they didn't capture his game. He could overpower you without touching you. An imposing physical force that defined elusiveness. A ghost cut from granite.
How about them apples?
Barry was a perfect combination of vision, muscle, and speed who produced one untouchable oddity.
I saw a number the other day that said 500,000 guys have played college football in the last 50 years. This guy undoubtedly had the best season of any of them ever.
The greatest season ever worth debating, but good luck finding the other side.
I think he's the greatest player ever in college football. It's a lasting legacy forever.
Yeah, the Cowboys family might be a little bit biased, but a lot of us certainly share that belief. I kid you not, I get goosebumps seeing those highlights. And here is Barry Sanders, who again was in Tokyo when he won it and has not yet been back. Barry, stand up. Congratulations. The silver anniversary Heisman Trophy season. What does it mean to be around this group in person for the first time?
It's amazing. It brings back so many memories. It meant so much to my university and my family. It literally changed my life the day I was announced a winner.
Did you have any sense at the time, any little sense, how significant that rushing total would be, that record that nobody's really gotten close to, much less in 11 games?
Well, I mean, not really, but I would have to say, you know, I grew up watching the game so closely before I entered college. I knew about all these guys. Earl Campbell's, Tony Dorsett's, Billy Sims, the list goes on and on. And so I realized that that was something truly unique and special.
You look fit. You look like you can still play. we'll see you at the golden anniversary, Barry Sanders. You know, like Barry, Andre Williams exploded down the stretch to join the 2,000-yard club. In fact, Andre needs just 84 yards in his bowl game to reach the fourth highest yardage total in any season in history. He's the son of Jamaican parents, a first-generation American who just graduated Boston College with a 3.0 a semester early on Thursday, the day he also won the Doak Walker Award. Congratulations. That's worth the handshake. You know, Andre sort of languished for 3 years before finally bursting forth this season in Steve Adazio's rebranded offense. The pensive Punisher. Physical and philosophical. Andre is a deep thinking, downhill running dichotomy. Gracious mama's boy who delights in demoralizing defenders. Break their tackles, then break their wills. Andre applies signature stiff arms, open hand punches, powerful and perfectly timed.
Look at that stiff arm, that's embarrassing.
Inspired by the Vikings' Adrian Peterson. Number 44 literally carries an offense with little mystery, but lots of muscle. For this aspiring author, the dramatic closing chapter at BC redeems his difficult early days. Faith and perseverance rewarded with a gratifying final bow. Andre grew up a sprinter. He's got underrated speed. 26 runs of 20-plus yards, by far the most this season, and the most by any back in the last 10 years. He also had almost 1,000 yards after contact. Now, another rugged dude who's run for 300 yards in a game. In fact, he did it twice this year. Northern Illinois' quarterback, Jordan Lynch. He also, by the way, threw for 23 touchdowns. Credit the ex-Husky coach, Jerry Kill, who believed in Lynch and left behind Northern Illinois' first ever Heisman contender. Bring them on. Bruising collisions embraced. Contact welcome. This quarterback believes a few body blows just light his fire and lift his game. Six is the perfect number for a touchdown machine. Obvious strength with subtle instincts. Shifting weight to take a shot and still go forward. Lynch is the lead Husky. Driven, willful, enthusiastic. And an underappreciated passer. Self-taught, sound mechanics, snapping off deep throws with quick release. Precision that's rare, given a workload that can leave him gasping for air. Now, Jordan is the only FBS player to ever rush for 1,500 yards and throw 20 touchdown passes in the same season. He's done it both years that he's been a starting quarterback. He goes for his 13th win with the Huskies in the bowl game. They have never before done that. Tom, he's a likable guy. We forgive him his incorrect pizza preference as a Chicago guy.
We'll let him slide on that, Chris. Jordan, we start with you, joined by Jordan and Andre. This isn't the first time you've been around the Heisman Trophy. When you were 12 years old, St. Christina's football banquet, you, Johnny Lattner, and your hand on the Heisman. What, if anything, about that day helped make this day, this season possible, Jordan?
Yeah, back in sixth grade, you know, me and Johnny Lattner, he brought his Heisman Trophy to our football banquet. And, you know, I took a picture and had my hand on the Heisman Trophy. And, you know, ever since that day, you know, that really stuck out to me. And, you know, I know it'd be pretty special if I got a chance to make it to the ceremony and actually win it.
On your dorm wall for quite a while, you've had a list of goals at Northern Illinois. Where on that list was Heisman finalist?
You know, I never really had any really individual awards on it. I always had, you know, team-oriented stuff. And, you know, I just wanted the opportunity to get a chance, you know, play quarterback at the college level. And I knew if I had that opportunity, I can, you know, run away with it and, you know, make history.
Well, a chance that obviously was cashed in on very well. Andre, you know, there we've heard about how thoughtful you are in graduating in 3.5 semesters, but also you were a teacher's assistant in a course this season while you played called The Courage to Know. Yeah. What lesson do you hope you may have given your students through the way you played this season?
I think most of all, I'd like to let the kids know that really it's everything you put your mind to, things that it's you're capable of doing more. You're capable of doing more. And even the things that you think you're capable of, there's more after that. No matter what the circumstance is, you know, we came from two wins last year, 10 losses, and now this year we're bowl eligible.
Anyone who's seen you run has seen the trademark toughness and strength, which is a part of your style. How did your parents, as Chris mentioned, immigrants to this country from Jamaica, instill those values in you, Andre?
Well, you know, my parents, they're very hardworking people. There was a time in my father's life where he was living out of his car, and, you know, now he's a business owner. You know, just growing up around them, they really just instilled a strong work ethic in me. And, you know, my mom, she's a real spiritual person and, you know, just made me a God-conscious person. And I think that's really what kept me on the straight path.
Despite the weather, Andre's parents' plans are to try to make it home to Pennsylvania right after this show. Why? So that they can go to work tomorrow. Talk about a work ethic that has been passed on to their son. Well, from two players who've had great seasons in the present, we go to Joe Tessitore for some historical perspective. Tess?
And Tommy, we've been breaking so many Heisman historical barriers in recent years. You know, recently we had the first sophomore, we had the first freshman, and now tonight perhaps some more history as we may have the youngest player to win the Heisman. Of course, Florida State fans will tell you they know the other side of that trivia question. The oldest to win the Heisman, that was Chris Wankey, Florida State's last winner. And there is a comparison to be made here because Chris Wankey was so good with play-action pass here against Clemson from the one-yard line, accurate downfield. And a big part of what Jameis Winston has done this year, how about this? Same team, same opponent, same spot on the field, same success downfield. But he's really the best of both worlds when it comes to Florida State's Heisman winners because, of course, he has the running ability of Charlie Ward, the 1993 winner. Now, the Heisman has not been kind to running backs in recent years. We have two extraordinary running backs with us this year in the front row. We will start with the nation's leading rusher, Andre Williams, 2,102 rushing yards this season. In the history of the sport, only 8 men have rushed for more than that. 4 of them have won the Heisman Trophy. But it's the style of running in Steve Adazio's offense that's getting everybody's attention because it takes us back to those golden years of Heisman running backs. A guy like this, Earl Campbell, downhill, pad leverage, punishing linebackers and defensive backs. This is how Andre Williams arrived to the front row here in New York. He is the Heisman Trophy, the ultimate stiff arm, the punishing attack to be the nation's leading rusher. As for the other running back, Trey Mason, you talk about bursting on the scene late. Had a great year at his best when the team needed it. And I know you may cringe, Auburn fans, but it's comparable to the way the Heisman was recently won in 2009 with Alabama's lone winner, Mark Ingram. You remember that year when it was a muddled race towards the end, and then in the SEC title game, he was at his best against a top 5 opponent. Well, last week, Trey Mason, SEC title game, top 5 opponent, 300-yard performance in what was the latest reshuffling of Heisman frontrunners we've seen in our polling through the years. Chris, a superstar quarterback and two extraordinary running backs that fit really well in with Heisman history. Well said, Tess. And another winner, Bo Jackson, held Auburn's single-season all-purpose yardage record for 28 years until Trey just crushed it during that frantic and fateful stretch run, capping the greatest one-season turnaround we've ever seen in this sport. Now, Trey also enjoyed a transformation from an eighth grader who once quit football because he thought it was a little bit too rough for him. Again and again and again and again. Sustained strength and stamina no one believed possible. 46 carries, 304 yards. Trey showed his heart, but no mercy on Missouri, churning out more in a half than the Tigers had permitted any team in any full game. One of these sensational season-capping crescendos, just a week after piercing the Crimson Tide. Auburn's quick renaissance owes much to Mason's resolute leadership. Trey transformed himself from a skinny speedster, building a sturdy base. Rare power and balance make him a tackler's nightmare. Okay, going back a decade, Trey is the only guy to rush for 100 yards in seven games during an SEC season. That's a lot of football against a lot of rugged defenses. Now, Trey was just telling me that during Cam Newton's Heisman season, he was interested in the Tigers, committed midway through the season after Auburn took out Georgia, and then was excited to see Cam Newton stand up here and have his name called. Well, last night, two talented and deserving high school athletes were honored here for their achievements on the field, in the classroom, and in their community. Let's congratulate this year's winners of the Wendy's High School Heisman, Emily Granger of Easton, Maryland, and Andrew Miner of East Greenwich, Rhode Island. Congratulations, Emily and Andrew. Fine young Americans like this are not quite ready to step into the Heisman House. Here's the best and the worst from that institution.
Hey, Ty.
Dang it, Barry.
What's that? Man, he's quick.
Really? You filled my bedroom with footballs?
And a water balloon.
Lemonade on the front porch? What are you guys, 80?
Kids these days. Lemonade on the front porch? What are you guys, 80?
Kids these days, Earl. I mean.
I like the wardrobe department there. Inside the Best Buy Theater, we are about less than 15 minutes away. The Heisman Trophy presentation presented by Nissan, the 79th winner, just ahead.
More than 60 years, Wrangler's been making jeans more comfortable. They feel good and wear strong. To me, Wrangler jeans are the most comfortable jeans you'll ever wear. And that's guaranteed.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans are built with a U-shape construction. They don't cut into you like jeans with a V pattern.
No matter what you're doing or where you're going, nothing beats Wrangler comfort. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans, guaranteed.
Let's do gifts. No, let's do surprises. Yes. Yes. Bingo. Let's do confidence. Let's do how did you know? Let's see what's in Santa's bag. And nail it. Let's do this. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Save $30 on this mechanics tool set, just $49.97. Husky hand tools guaranteed forever.
Let's go, baby, let's go! Sunday Night Football, Ravens Lions, 8:25 Eastern on ESPN.
It's the most wonderful week of the year. Capital One Bowl Week, December 21st through January 1st on the ESPN networks and ABC. College football lives here.
You guys got a great deal.
We went to cars.com and used their side-by-side comparison tool, so it was easy, but...
But you were hoping for a little more drama?
Kinda, yeah.
Try this.
Rachel?
Scott, the baby's yours.
Steven,
what we have, it's so real.
No.
You should leave her.
Oh, my, Steven.
Better?
Yeah, that was perfect.
That was great.
Get the right car without all the drama. Cars.com. All drive, no drama.
You use your index finger for almost everything. The only smartphone with a rear key, LG G2. Easy volume control. Easy self-portrait. Easy control with your index finger. Learning from you. LG G2.
A 30 for 30 film, Youngstown Boys follows us. Maurice Clarett, Jim Tressel, both from that town, won the 2002 national championship at Ohio State, but their careers went different directions. 30 for 30 Youngstown Boys coming up right after our show. Can you see in the faces of our six finalists the promise of greatness? You see, Jordan there grew up in Chicago playing football in the streets and parks, wherever he could. Andre, his brothers, Irvin Jr., Kareem, older sister Crystal, also here tonight. Trey, back when he believed football was too rough at age three. Come a long way since then. AJ, also a three-year-old, striking the pose down there in Mobile. How about Johnny Baseball there? Did he always plan on achieving great things in New York? And look at Jameis Winston as a 10-year-old. Is this a confident look, folks? He was playing football at four against kids who were 7 and 8. Like Seminole quarterbacks, Charlie Ward and Chris Winkie right behind him there. Jameis is a two-sport star. Baseball is a passion for him. As a football teammate, though, LaMarcus Joyner said this week, sometimes leadership is appointed to a player. Others are just born to lead. It became obvious pretty early on that Jameis was also born to play quarterback. He had a notebook that detailed the qualities that a quarterback should have and the best pass routes to use against various defenses, cover two and cover three. When he created that, he was 12 years old, so it's no surprise that the prodigy is fulfilling his promise. But this fast, not even he expected it. Defensive backs, batters, base runners, all beaten by a powerful arm attached to a delicate hand. Jameis has touch that can't be taught, precise accuracy, produced by feathery feel, like Larry Bird's jumper and the Golden Bears' putter.
Maybe.
Yes, sir!
Rare skills set in motion by a rapid brain, observing, absorbing, retaining, applying. A 6'5", 230-pound prodigy playing full throttle, even sprinting 34 yards downfield to throw a block. At Winston's core, confidence, the gift of organic leadership, an alpha, authentic, never arrogant.
We ain't leaving without a victory. We ain't leaving without a victory. Hey, my brother, put a smile on your face.
I got ready for a big game at Clemson. The rookies aren't supposed to be this resistant to pressure. A 70% passer facing the blitz, 12 yards per attempt, 20 touchdowns. All those are the best among all AQ quarterbacks as a freshman. Tom, some are calling Jameis's season one of the elite seasons in quarterbacking history.
Pretty hard to argue with it statistically, certainly, Chris. Jameis, it's a team game with team goals. This is the ultimate individual award in the sport. What individual is most responsible for you being here tonight?
Probably my dad. And I admired that man my whole life. And the way he instilled, confidence, leadership, and just that charisma about me, man. It's just, I'm just blessed to have a dad in my life.
Earlier this week, when you talked about all that's happened off the field over the last month, you said, I know I've done nothing wrong. What, if anything, do you feel has been misunderstood about you, Jameis?
Well, I'm a family man, and I love life, and I love everything to deal with it, and I love my college experience, and I got to grow. Every day I go out there, I got to be a better man, I got to do this and that, but I'm growing, and I know I did nothing wrong, and I say that, and I was eventually vindicated, but people just got to know that, I mean, I just love life, and every day I'm going to carry myself, and I'm going to get better every single day.
Just 19 years old, if your name does get called, you'd be the youngest winner in the history of the Heisman Trophy. How old do you feel?
I mean, sometimes the way I be walking around, I feel like I'm your age. And I know you look like you're 21, but I'm just saying. It'll just be a blessing. Obviously, I cannot do what Johnny did last year, but it'll be a blessing to my family and everything.
We talk about age. January 6th, Jameis will turn 20. Just so happens to be the day he'll play Auburn for the national championship. Pretty good setup there for Kirk, Lee, and Dez. Guys?
Tommy, a little shot there,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, yeah. That was a line of the night.
Yeah, a little shot across the bow. We've watched him play all year. We were anticipating him playing a year ago, and now we've had a chance to see him. What stands out about him
to
you?
Well, I think the best thing is he would be the youngest player ever to win Heisman. That's a tremendous honor. He had a great year, you know. He took the Noles to an undefeated season. But I tell you what I'm extremely proud of. I played quarterback. Mm-hmm. I played the same position, the same team as he did just 57 years before. Holy mackerel, time flies.
Yeah, Coach, it really does.
Time flies.
Yes, sir, no doubt about that. I was so impressed with this young man Labor Day when he played against Pitt, and he had just an outstanding performance, 25 of 27 for over 300 yards and 4 touchdowns. And then he just started to get better as the season got older. Like you saw the graphic about the against the blitz. When people brought extra rushers to Jameis Winston, this kid got better, completing 70% of his passes for 20 touchdowns. I mean, unbelievable for a freshman to be so composed and so cool under pressure like that, week in and week out. And we were at that Clemson game. And that clip they showed of that young man in the locker room, getting his guys ready for the game, but at the same time, remaining loose. It just speaks volumes about the kid's leadership.
I don't know if we've ever seen a freshman provide this kind of leadership for a team that's going to go play in the national championship. And the way the seniors, and there's some great seniors on this team, the way they've been so accepting of that leadership. Yeah. To me, Chris, that's what I think a lot of people will remember about this team and, of course, about Jameis and the success he had this year.
Yeah, it is amazing that 20th birthday, the day the Seminoles will take on Auburn. Jameis told us earlier this week he does plan to celebrate his birthday in that beautiful setting. The Tigers may have some other ideas. We celebrate tonight the golden anniversary of the Heisman Trophy won by Roger Staubach. It was a very important Heisman Trophy won by the quarterback of the Naval Academy at a time which John F. Kennedy's assassination had the nation mourning. Roger marking the occasion in Philadelphia, watching Navy beat Army yet again. Heisman Trophy legends, please come to the stage. A moment is here. We'll have the announcement of the winner of the 79th Heisman Trophy after this timeout. We'll also get the winning margin and the full order of the top six. Guys, come on up.
Ready to run your lines? Okay. Who helps you focus on your recovery?
Yo, 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 Aflac.
Wow. That one's horrible. Pays you cash when you're sick or hurt.
Aflac.
Love it.
Hate it.
Helps you focus on getting back to normal.
Aflac.
Aflac,
I am so fired.
You're on in 5. Duck.
When you're sick or hurt, Aflac pays you cash. Find out more at Aflac.com.
How could switchgrass in Argentina change engineering in Dubai, aluminum production in South Africa, and the aerospace industry in the U.S.? At T. Rowe Price, we understand the connections of a complex global economy. It's just one reason over 70% of our mutual funds beat their 10-year Lipper average. T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a prospectus or summary prospectus with investment information, risks, fees, and expenses to read and consider carefully before investing.
It's beautiful, sweetheart.
Can I help you?
Oh, it's our fridge.
It's on layaway.
Why layaway? Take it home today at Rent-A-Center and pay it off while you enjoy it at home.
Take game day to the next level at the new sports bar at Dave & Buster's. Get in the action with massive TVs, plus fuel your fun with $5 apps and beer specials, and play new games in the midway. Dave & Buster's, the only place to watch the games and play the games.
This Friday, America's top critics are raving about Saving Mr. Banks.
Now, where is Mr. Disney?
Oh, Walt, you gotta call me Walt.
Yeah! And now, it's a Golden Globe nominee for Best Actress, Emma Thompson.
Shall we begin?
Rolling Stone calls it magic.
My imagination was absolutely on fire.
The Chicago Sun-Times declares it one of the year's best films.
I swear, every time a person walks into a movie house, they will rejoice.
Saving Mr. Banks, rated PG-13. Now playing in select cities everywhere this Friday.
He's really good. Gonna be a great one.
MVP front runners.
Yeah, I love competition. I try to step up to the challenge.
And a ferocious rivalry renewed.
We was one game away. They've been in the finals. And they do forget that.
Titles are won in June, but statements are made in December. Pacers, Heat, the NBA on ESPN. Indiana, Miami at 7 Eastern. Chicago, Houston at 9:30. Presented by State Farm, Wednesday.
The 2013 Heisman Trophy presentation is presented by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy, and in part by Aflac, official partner of the Heisman Trophy, and T. Rowe Price. Understanding the connections of a complex global economy. Invest with confidence.
They did.
And welcome back inside the Best Buy Theater, the Heisman Trophy presentation presented by Nissan. Love this moment every year when the past Heisman winners join us and the new family member is announced. We have a good turn at 24 of them representing the 50s right around to, well, as recent as last year. From the 50s, John Lattner and Paul Horney, Notre Dame. John David Crow, Texas A&M. From the 60s, John Hewitt, Mike Garrett, Gary Beben. From the 70s, with the fancy lid, Johnny Rogers, Archie Griffin, Tony Dorsett. Down on the floor here, Earl Campbell showing his toughness, sockless on a very cold winter night. Earl, good to see you down there. And Billy Sims. And from the 80s, George Rogers, Mike Rozier. We met Doug Flutie earlier, Tim Brown. And, of course, Barry Sanders, the silver anniversary Heisman Trophy winner. From the 90s, say hello to Ty Detmer, our buddy Desmond Howard, Gino Toretta, and Danny Werfel. And from the 2000s, again, Chris Winkie, Eric Crouch, Jason White, and down front, Johnny Manziel. Time now for the big announcement, the season's biggest handoff. Please welcome Heisman trustee Jim Corcoran. Jim, welcome.
Thanks, Chris. Great job as always. Good evening. For those of you at home watching on TV, and for the fortunate few who are able to get into the room tonight, it's with great honor that I stand before you to announce the 2013 Heisman Memorial Trophy. The Heisman Trophy Trust, stewards of this prestigious award, is a not-for-profit organization whose mission is to support amateur athletics, and whose goal is to provide greater opportunities for the youth of our country. My fellow trustees and I wholeheartedly believe in the importance of this mission and the work of more than 100 noteworthy organizations that we've supported through the years. We've been able to accomplish our goals with the help of our generous sponsors. I believe that has made us all winners. Also, In that spirit, I think it's important that we recognize our former Heisman Trophy winners that are here tonight, as well as the friends and families of those who have supported and encouraged these young, exceptional athletes. Since 1935, the Heisman Trophy has grown in stature to become the most coveted award in amateur athletics. The trophy will be awarded tonight to the most outstanding college football player in the nation. The Heisman epitomizes great athletic ability, leadership, diligence, passion, and most of all, hard work. We applaud each one of these finalists here tonight.